Hello, and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. Once a week, I pick some topic of interest in C++ and dig into it with some live coding. In this episode, I'm going to discuss one of my favorite upcoming features of C++ 17, Standard Invoke. And like all of these upcoming features for C++ 17, you can find documentation about it on cppreference.com. The documents make this look rather complicated, and there's lots of things that are like return standard result of t, some function call, and lots of forwarding references and things that, like what does this do? And the possible implementation of it looks particularly hairy. And even the examples, I feel like, are more complicated than it needs to be. So I just want to run over this. What we've got is a function that gives us a uniform interface into calling callable things. Okay, let's say we have this function called do something, my favorite function. And it's just going to return a value. And, well, let's see, we want it to take something. Something like this. And by the way, I'm trying out for the first time a new setup of my video screencasting VM here, so sorry in advance if I messed anything up in the display. Let me know if you have any comments. So in our main, let's say we want to do standard invoke of do something 5. And so this is going to just return the value 10. And let's make sure we got the correct header. It is in the functional header. And that's pretty straightforward. So let's try compiling it. And we have to use G++ 6 to get this. And we need to put it in C++ 17 mode, which is currently C++ 1z. And of course, we missed the obvious, as usual. And there we go. Builds, it returns 10, just like we expect. So this, maybe isn't the most amazing thing in the world, but in giving us a uniform interface into calling methods and functions and anything that's callable, what we gain is not having to know things that are considered rather esoteric in the C++ world, such as how to invoke a member function pointer. So to give an example of this, we're going to create a struct. And we're going to give it a method. We're going to give it its own do something. And we're going to give it its own values. So this is, not anything terribly complex here. And we want to return j plus i, and in fact, I'm going to make this not const. And there we go. So if we have our struct s, and we can call s dot do something of 3, and we expect that to return a 8. Let's make sure that all works. It does, it returns 8. All right. Now, if we wanted to use a member function pointer for some reason, and there's lots of reasons to in template programming in C++, but I'm going to try to keep this example as simple as possible. So we've got something. Let's say we're going to do a auto function pointer equals s do something. And let's make sure even that just compiles. All right, no big deal. If we want to call this function pointer fp, then we have to do s dot star fp and then pass it that. And I'm pretty sure that I got this correct. And in fact, let's give it a different value just so that we know where we are. So we expect this to print now 7. And yes, this works. So you might ask, why in the world would you want to do something? And the actual type of FP here, which I will try to get correct, is int s colon colon star int, and let's call this fp2, and equal that to s colon colon do something, and we will take a second stab at this and make sure we're still getting all of our syntax correct. And we are. Very good. So why you might want to do this is, let's say you've got a second member function with the exact same signature. We're going to call it do something too. Instead of adding them, we're going to multiply them. And now here, there might be a reason to, in some switch of our block, like if true, fp2 equals s do something, else make it equal to do something. Actually, let's swap these around. So if it's true, then fp2 equals do something too. And hey, still getting all the syntax correct. So now on our second call here, we're getting 1 times 5 essentially, because j has been initialized to 5 up there, and we're calling do something too, which is why we get 5 printed out as our last result. So this is all hairy and complicated, and if we want to work with a bunch of different types in some sort of templated function, it starts to get out of hand. So instead, we can do standard invoke do something on s with the value 2. And we will print this result also, and I'm going to change this one more time. Let's make this 10. So we're expecting 15, 10 plus 5 to be printed out here. And that worked. So this gives us this universal interface into calling anything that's callable with a set of parameters. It's pretty darn cool. And if you do any sort of passing around of function pointers or passing around of member function pointers, or any kind of templated programming that can take callable things, this could potentially really save you a lot of effort and the number of overloads that you need to implement, depending on whether you're getting a const thing or a volatile thing or a free function, member data. You can even, actually, this is a great example. For this example, instead of calling do something to, we're going to say j of s. So we can even use this to access member data. I hope. Yes. So that prints a 5 out. So we're saying access the member data called J on the object called S. Really cool. So I hope you enjoy it. Maybe find a use for it in your own code. Be sure to subscribe, follow me on Twitter, and check out any of the links below.